Hello from the Bureau with an update on Tropical Cyclone Oma. Earlier this week, it looked as though Oma would stay well to Australia's east, but the most likely scenario now is for Oma to approach the southern Queensland coast over the weekend and possibly even make landfall. In terms of exactly how Oma will track, well, the devil will be in the detail, and much of that detail is still becoming clearer over the coming days. Right now, Tropical Cyclone Oma is a Category 2 system with wind gusts to around 155 kilometres per hour near the centre. Oma lies just to the southwest of New Caledonia and for now is still in the area of responsibility of Fiji, who monitor tropical cyclones in the southwest Pacific Ocean. One possibility we talked about earlier this week was the potential for Cyclone Oma to move west into the Coral Sea on Wednesday today, rather than stay well to the east. Well, that is the scenario we're looking at now. Currently, around 1,010 kilometres to the northeast of Brisbane, Oma will continue tracking slowly towards the south-southwest over the next few days as a Category 2 system. Cyclones are always a challenge to forecast and often have a life of their own, particularly in the Coral Sea. That's why we include this grey shaded area around the official forecast track, which shows the range of possibilities still on the cards for how Cyclone Oma may move. Much of how Oma tracks as we head into the weekend will actually depend on the movement of this high pressure system to the south, centred near Tasmania. As the ridge of high pressure builds and jumps across into the Tasman Sea, we expect it to push Oma back towards the west-northwest towards the Queensland coast. It is very uncommon for tropical cyclones to move so far south and potentially impact along the southeast Queensland coast, but it's not unprecedented. In our history, we've even seen rare cyclones in New South Wales. Again, there's a lot of details still to become clear about exactly how Oma will eventually track and develop. But it is likely that we'll need to issue a cyclone watch for parts of the southern Queensland coast as Cyclone Oma moves closer to account for the risk of coastal gales and heavy rainfall. That potential for heavy rainfall is greatest along the coast and adjacent inland south of about Bundaberg as Cyclone Oma approaches. Rain would most likely develop from late Saturday, and the risk would be enhanced if Oma eventually makes landfall. In the meantime, and well ahead of Oma's approach towards southeast Queensland, don't forget about the already very dangerous ocean conditions along our coastline. A severe weather warning is currently in place for abnormally high tides south of 1770, where king tides are being exacerbated by large waves and heavy swell generated by Cyclone Oma from a distance. These high tides will peak tomorrow morning and on Friday morning, when water levels may exceed the normal level of the highest tide of the year by around 1 metre. We could see significant beach erosion and inundation of low-lying areas. A warning for hazardous surf continues along the Queensland coast from the Capricornia down to the Gold Coast, and on Thursday that hazardous surf will extend down as far in New South Wales as the Cough Coast. It's important to follow Tropical Cyclone Oma over the next few days. She's likely to have a few twists and turns left in her yet, and forecasts and warnings may change rapidly as more information and new information comes to hand. Stay tuned to the BOM website and app for the latest forecasts and warnings, and follow us on social media for updates. And please follow all advice from emergency services.